ഗുഡ് മോർണിംഗ് ഫ്രണ്ട്സ്. മൈ ടോപ്പിക് ഈസ് റെഫറൻസ് സ്കിൽസ്. സോ റെഫറൻസ് സ്കിൽസ് ഇൻ ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ലാംഗ്വേജ് ആർ ക്രൂഷ്യൽ ഫോർ എഫക്റ്റീവ് കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേഷൻ ആൻഡ് കോംപ്രിഹെൻഷൻ വിച്ച് ഈസ് അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡിംഗ്. സോ ദി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻസ് ഓഫ് റെഫറൻസ് സ്കിൽസ് ഈസ് ടു മാസ്റ്റർ ഇറ്റ് ഫോർ എൻഹാൻസിങ് ക്ലാരിറ്റി ആൻഡ് കോഹറൻസ് ഇൻ ബോത്ത് റൈറ്റിംഗ് ആൻഡ് സ്പീക്കിംഗ്. വാട്ട് ആർ റെഫറൻസ് സ്കിൽസ്? Reference skills involve the ability to use words or phrases to refer to other elements within a text or conversation, and it also helps in maintaining cohesion and coherence by linking different parts of a discourse. And there are three types of reference skills. First one is anaphoric reference, second one is categoric reference, and third one is exorphic reference. So we can look into the first one, which is the anaphoric reference, which means it involves using pronouns or other words to refer back to previously mentioned entities. For example, John lost his wallet, and in the next sentence, the pronoun he is used to indicate John. Next one is categoric reference, and it refers to forward to something mentioned later in the discourse. That is, this book is excellent. That is, the book is described as excellent, and then says that inside that books it provides valuable insights into the topic. So it is mentioning the further thing about that book. Third one is exorphic reference, and it involves referring to something outside the immediate text or conversation. That is, suddenly is telling something which is out of context. That is, look at the beautiful sunset, like that. Then what are the importance of using reference skills? First one is, it enhances clarity and coherence in communication by reducing ambiguity and facilitating understanding. And also, the proper use of reference skills ensures that readers or listeners can easily follow the flow of information. And which are the strategies for improving reference skills? That is, to engage in activities which require identifying and using different types of references, and also encourage active reading and listening, which helps in paying close attention to how references are used in different contexts, and then offering feedback and correction, which helps in receiving feedback on to how to use reference skills and work on areas that need improvement. And next are the common challenges in reference skills. That is, first one, ambiguity, unclear antecedents, and misuse of pronouns, which are common challenges in mastering reference skills. And also, addressing issues like practice, feedback, increased awareness can help to overcome those challenges. And it provides more examples for practice covering various types of reference skills. And also, guided exercises can offer structured exercises to reinforce understanding and the application of reference skills. So reference skills are very essential for effective communication in English language, and continuous practice and application are key to mastering reference skills and becoming proficient communicators. Thank you.